Hello, my name is Marcus Day, and the title of my presentation is Who for Brick and Mortar. And what that's going to be talking about is Black Friday sales and how that ties in to actual storefronts compared to internet websites. Our first slide is going to talk about retail setbacks, such as low wages and increasing layoffs, Amazon, eBay, and Overstock having great sales and how that factors into the brick and mortar stores. We have robotics developments, which leads to a decrease in jobs because people are getting taken out and being replaced by robots because they're able to do their jobs more efficiently and cheaper. And we have improved shipping tactics, so we also need less jobs to do the shipping. So I have a quote here from Jimmy Chin, the USNews.com. Decreased job postings, layoffs, and vacant storefronts. By looking at these headlines at the retail industry, any casual observer would believe the industry is dying. Here are the facts. We have a sales increase in Black Friday from 2016 to 2017 to $682 billion. Company growth in the sector targets investing $7 billion into the customer experience. Companies are able to make profits with lean thinking. 101.7 million people walked into storefronts last year on Black Friday. That's 30% more than in 2015. And a 4% overall rise from 2016 in sales. That's higher than the average of 2.5%. So what all that shows to me is that brick and mortar stores are still doing fairly well in comparison to the headlines that everybody says that it's dying. And here we just have a graph showing US retail sales growth from 2006 to 2016. So you can see that in 2006 it was at 5.2%, and in 2011 it again reached 5%, but then it tailed off down to 3.2%, and since then it's been about steady. So really, retail sales are about where they should be in comparison to recent years. So our expectations for the season: 500 to 550,000 seasonal hires, increased in-store only deals before and after Thanksgiving. There's expected to be a competitive work environment, which is going to drive quality on not just the products and sales being offered, but also the customer experience. If customers have a good experience, they're more likely to come back and buy more or recommend certain deals at certain stores. Traditional companies are growing their cyber sector for greater coverage. And the 2017 holiday shopping season is already off to a healthy start at $5 billion in sales. So tying into the companies growing their cyber sector, and what goes unseen is a tremendous amount of resources stores are directing to their back-end operations. An example of that would be Target announcing a $7 billion plan to improve in-store and online customer experience. To do this, higher salary positions like web app developers, marketing experts, and business analysts need to be hired. These positions take away from seasonal help because they're higher salary jobs, and the money just isn't there to pay these seasonal workers anymore. The market. There's an estimated $292 billion in US retail sales. We find that Black Friday shoppers are actually more active on their phones than shopping during the typical holidays, and that's also from Jimmy Chin of the US News. We have an increased stock from the brick and mortar stores during the holiday season. You know, they're still making those sales and that's proved by their stock. If they weren't making a bunch of sales, their inventory levels wouldn't be increasing during the holiday season. Cyber-only companies are entering brick and mortar sector, such as Amazon in 2016 purchasing Whole Foods. That's showing that you can't just live on the internet and be able to continue to compete with brick and mortar stores. And Amazon buying into Whole Foods is a great example of that. So the competition. During the 2016 period, 56 out of 61 days resulted in over $1 billion in revenue. Smartphones accounted for 41% of online retail visits in 2016. So that's showing that a lot of people are in their stores on their smartphones, trying to find the best deals, comparing and swapping out. If they're in a store that already has the best deal, they might go in there and buy that. The Holiday 2016 saw that desktop visits purchased at 2.4 times the rate of smartphone visits, indicating that consumers still relied on their smartphones to research and then the desktop to buy. It was a $4.5 billion opportunity cost. That's showing you that they're in their stores looking on the phone, searching for the best deal, and they might go in the store, see what they feel things out, and then go home, and they sit down at the desktop, and then they decide which product they want to buy and where they want to buy it from. In 2016, there was also a new record high for Cyber Monday sales of $6.6 billion. So the takeaway from all this, traditional stores are still seeing profits. We still need traditional retailers for the foreseeable future to buy unique goods such as jewelry, groceries, cars. As far as I know, we haven't found a way that we can purchase milk, vegetables, and fruit and ship that and it still be consumable for the consumer. Consumer trust and spending is high, which is great, because if the consumers trust the market, trust the stores, they're going to continue to keep buying products. Online shopping is the biggest retail avenue. And I just have a couple takeaways also from, in comparison to people thinking that traditional stores are dying. Vacant storefronts are common and help to support the cause that retail is dying. They are not a victim of trends happening now so much as they are obvious reminders of our past mistakes. Over the last century, American consumerism blossomed and a frenzy of malls and shopping centers opened in the 80s. The right size of space per person, the incorrect size of space per person was calculated. This all resulted in the US being a tremendous outlier in retail space. Nowadays, companies want to maximize every square inch of space they have, resulting in decreased need for large stores. So you see the stores getting smaller and smaller because they're learning how to maximize each and every square inch of that. And they don't need all that extra space. By maximizing each inch, they're able to cut down on cost. And that's also from Jimmy Chin of the US News. And here are my references, and thank you for your time.